So we're going to today grow passion fruit. This is a passion fruit that fell on the ground up in my friend's house. It's Australian passion fruit. They're very sweet. They're more yellow than the ones here in the Philippines. So I'm just going to take it. I should have done it beforehand. I'll wash them out, I think. You can leave them in this. Some of them are a bit moldy. I'm just going to stick them all into one big pot. And then,
okay, if you can't find a fruit to get the seeds from, I'll put a link down in the description where you can buy some.
I'll put them into a glass and wash them off. From experience, I know good seeds nearly always will sink to the bottom, so whatever stays on the top, it'll remove the placenta from some of the seeds, but some of the seeds are floating here, and they might not be viable, they might be rotten or something. And as I have piles of them here, I am not going to. So you can see most of the seeds down here in the bottom, they're the ones we're going to sow. I don't have a pot that's low, high, a big one, so maybe a basin would be better for sowing them. So I'm just going to sow them into this one. I've just put compost in it. It's normal compost, that it's not commercial. It's from gardening compost. And I'm going to spread the and spread them around. They're starting to come out now, the real seeds. I'm not going to be fussy, because they can grow in clumps. I'll spread them out a little bit more. I'll spread them out a little bit more. There's a big lump of them there. So we just spread them out like this, the seeds. Don't be so fussy. It's a fruit. It's a fruit, you know. You have lots of seeds in it. A few more in there. Anyway, you're going to have way more than you'll ever want to do. But what I do, as always, what I do is I make extra ones and give them away. And I've given away so many different plants. Now the seeds are all kind of spread out. Oh, there's a few clump there, and there's a bit of placenta there. I wouldn't worry about that. So then I'm just going to cover that with more compost, about a quarter of an inch, maybe 6 or 8 millimeters, maybe. Not too high. And we're going to put this. It's not going to be in. Well, there'll be a little bit of sun here in the morning, very little. It's going to be in. It's hot. Well, everywhere's hot here. So I'm going to water it in. I don't think I'll tamp it. I might give it a little tamp down. Not really. The water itself, when I water it now, I'm going to water it with mist. I'll go over and get some mist water. And there's going to be big side left on this, but that's not going to be a problem. When this gets big, we'll put it out in the sun, it'll be fine. So I've misted them over now, and I put a little bit more soil on top of them, and then I just leave them. Okay, it's been 13 days since we put them seeds down. They're still coming up. It's been extremely hot here. I didn't think they'd grow at all. You can see other ones coming up here. You can see when they come up like the stem comes up and then the leaf after them. That's how you will know them. This is not one here. These are the ones, the round ones. This is a, I'd say that's a, it could be a chili, could be a pepper. I won't pull it out now to upset the roots of the other, just let it grow for a while. When we get about 30 of these or 40 of them, then we'll give it more sun. I'll give it a little bit of sun today, but it's unseasonably hot here. It's it was 36 degrees. So I left these for way too long, but anyway, it's growing up. I left it here in the pot, and I got too busy. I had to go away for a couple of weeks, so I had to go up north after Christmas, and it's after growing up along the bamboo here where we have orchids. And I'm just going to dig these up, pull these up out of it and stick them in the ground at the back. And because I have to run away again, and somebody will look after them then. They don't need much looking after, but these are the ones from seed, and they grow so quick inside the pot. So I'll just stick them in the ground somewhere at the back, and we'll stick some bamboo up or something like that. I didn't really show you when I put them into the ground, I don't think. I'll try and see, can I find the footage. When I put them down here, I just put two plants here, and they're growing all the way from there, all along the wall, up along. We put a trellis
So maybe one should have done. We have eaten some fruits, but the main crop is coming soon. There's a fruit there. Look, see there. There's a fruit. We took about 6 fruit off it at the moment. You see the flowers? No. We have about 30 or 40 of them at the moment. So I'll come back to you when I'll wind up the video in. You'll see it in a couple of minutes. See all the flowers here. So more up there. I expect to have maybe in 2 weeks. Well, look at the flowers down here. These are all going to be fruits in a couple of days. And the weather is getting even warmer now. So now we're going to start harvesting some of them. You won't always see them. There's about 30 fruit here. You need to pull back the leaves. Like, you can come back up here. You can see, oh yeah, that's nice and soft. That's ripe. You can see, nice and yellow, a few little things on it. Let's have a look here. Yeah, that's ripe as well. You just have to pull back the leaves. You won't see them all the time. Like, if I pull back the leaves here, like this, you can see underneath, there's another ripe one. Yeah. And the whole way along. And we've already taken many off this. These ones down here now are not quite ripe yet. Do you see these ones? They're still very... You can feel them, they're harder, plus they're more green. They'll be ripe in a few days' time, and that one, almost ripe. Now, here's one here. It's not ripe yet, almost ripe, but it's still a little bit hard. So we'll go down further. You just lift it up like this. That one's just about ripe. You probably leave it in the bowl, it'll ripen in another day. Like most fruit, and that's not ripe. So you just pull them up and you look under. Here's a big, big one down here. That is not ripe yet. That is pure green. And so basically when they get a bit of suntan, then they are ripe. You look in underneath, you can find them. We've taken off some from here the other day. You just have to look around. They don't just pop up. Here's some here, a bundle of them in here, small ones. See them here? They're only starting to grow. This is a bad one here. Something wrong with that. Yeah, just get rid of that. That one didn't grow right. Maybe didn't get enough water. So we'd get about, you should be able to get about 5 or 6 every day. And so I'll show you now then how we eat them. So now Eden's going to show you how we cut them and how we eat them here in the Philippines.
I make a juice out of it.
Could do with a sharper knife, but anyway. So I'm just going to zoom in and let you see what it's like inside for people. Some people don't know what passion fruit is.
See?
You use a spoon and you take out these little seeds, and these ones would be sweeter than the normal ones in the Philippines. These are, as I told you earlier, they're from Australia. So you can take it out, or you can eat them out of the... You can eat them directly from this, or you can take them out. There's not an awful amount in them, but they're very, very strong flavor, sweet, bitter. Okay, I'm going to taste it. I've had it before. It's tangy, sweet. That's why it's called passion fruit. Thank you very much for watching this video from seeds to fruit of our passion fruit. Here in the Philippines, they're common to grow up along trees and everything like that. They are not specialty, and for people overseas, they might think you probably pay big money for them there, I don't know. But over here, they're probably one of the cheapest fruits you can buy, and they've got a nice tang off them. And thank you very much for watching. And if you like this video, please subscribe to our channel up here. Up there?